I agree. Hello, hello. Good evening. Firstly, huge apologies on the delay, just getting everyone together took us a while. It's actually an exceptional day for all of us for various reasons. This film marks so many firsts and so many associations, so much emotion in this collaboration that it is difficult for me to encompass all of it. But I have to say that one of our biggest and deepest honors is that we're remaking a film that was a benchmark film in 1969. The original Ittefaq broke ground on so many levels. It was the first on many accounts, especially when Mr. Rajesh Khanna, the superstar of that era, known for his music and his musical record, broke ground and broke myths with actually accepting a songless film that went on to be iconic in so many ways. It was a proud product from BR Films that was known very heavily for its story development and its story development unit. And of course, it brought Yash Chopra to the fore as a tremendous force to reckon with. A director who went on to make all kinds of path-breaking content, and Ittefaq definitely being the first in his foray into tremendous content. Remaking Ittefaq is a huge honor. And who better than his grandson to direct this film? Abhay Chopra helms the scenario with a tight rein. His adaptation of the original is new, it's inventful, and yet it has all the tropes that come with a whodunit, a crime suspense thriller, that they entirely warrant. The producer of this film are multiple. There's BR Films, there's Dharma Productions, and there's Red Chilies. And of course, we have the cast, who we're going to introduce you to very soon. So it's a combination of two brothers that have actually resulted in the force that Ittefaq is. Kapil Chopra, for everything that I've known him when he was as large as I was. He was an assistant to me in Kabhi Khushi Kabhi Gham before that in Mohabbate. And he went through the similar trajectory of weight loss. Then I put it all back on, but he's lost it all. And he went on to be a strong creative force at BR Films and proudly presenting his brother as a director with Ittefaq. Of course, held very strongly by their mother, Renu Chopra, who truly holds the reins of everything that happens in that studio. So it's pretty much strongly old school family, which is the way we like it. Not that I insinuate nepotism with that, but I say that it's to do with the love that a family can bring to cinema, which is what the thought really comes from. Today, when I speak of love and I talk about friendship, I talk about my own. I'm a result of my relationships in this industry. I started off with two men who actually gave me the strength to enter this industry. Aditya Chopra, who provided the platform, and Shah Rukh Khan, who gave me every reason to be a filmmaker. After that, in the last over nearly 20 years, we've gone on to create 10 pieces of work together. And each one has been special in so many different ways. Shah Rukh and I are not only best friends and family, but we're also collaborators who brought and tried to bring the essence of cinema to all of you in so many different ways and genres. Some mainstream family films, some iconic, intense experiences like Dear Zindagi, and for the first time we come together for a whodunit thriller, Ittefaq. It is my honor, it is my pleasure, and it is my privilege to work with the man, to know the man, to constantly interact with him, none other than the heartbeat of our industry, Shah Rukh Khan. Should we sit down or do you want to stand?
We have to sit down?
Yeah. Shah Rukh, welcome to your own film. And I have to say that when I was doing... अरे दे देंगे यार फोटो प्लीज, भगवान के लिए बात करने दो ना. मैं टॉक शो होस्ट हूँ, मैं ही बात करना चाहता हूँ, यही मेरा काम है. नमस्कार, स्वागत है आपका इस मंच पे. तो मैं कहना चाहता हूँ कि this when I was doing the math, then I realized this is the 10th film that we've collaborated on. It's been quite a journey, and I feel before we get into Ittefaq, I feel the one thing that you and I have always combated, or at least dealt with, is the fact that we constantly have to prove our intense love and family love for each other. Why do you think that is?
First of all, I'd just like to thank Karan and the whole team, which has got me here. And of course, Karan Johar, and before him, his father, Mr. Yash Johar, who actually treated me like a family when I came here and gave me opportunities to work with them. I worked with Yash Ji on Duplicate. And then our long association started with Kuch Kuch Hota Hai. And since then, yes, I have also seen different shades of love that have been connotated to me and Karan, from a friend to a brother, and on even higher levels, and then situations where we supposedly have fought. You know, in life, I believe that there are some relationships which don't need to be substantiated every time, to be explained every time. It irritates me, as a matter of fact, to keep on explaining to people that I love Karan, I love Hiru Aunty, I love his two new little babies very, very much, and they're so pretty, mashallah. And our relationship every time, if he's doing a film which is not with me, if I'm doing something which is with someone that Karan doesn't get along with, and there are lots of people at different times that Karan doesn't get along with, and then starts getting along with them, and then... So, because I'm a little outside of what happens around the world, so I can't keep tabs of his good times with who and bad times with who, and fortunately, unfortunately, I go on to be working with someone he must be hating at that point in time, and then I'm like... But it doesn't ever come in between the relationship we have shared. So if this perhaps a little inappropriate stage, place to say it, but once and for all, I've never had a problem with Karan Johar. I love him unconditionally, and so does he. We are like family, and inshallah we'll grow old together, and we'll be here at 107 on wheelchairs, launching new films, working together. May not be working together as director actors, but there'll always be this camaraderie, brotherhood. And I know one thing for a fact, that if ever, ever, Khuda na khasta, Karan is in trouble, I'll be the first guy to come and stand in front of him. If he's lost a lot of weight, then behind him, because then he'll be agile and cool and maybe able to protect me. We're always there for each other. So I don't know why people keep talking that. But now with so many people talking so many things, I think best is just to keep quiet and move on and make the films and do the work that we do.
Because it's amazing that, you know, when we go through this kind of a journey, yet you have to constantly encounter these questions. But it's, I think, in the past, and I think our work speaks for itself, and the love comes through in any case. Ittefaq is a special film on so many levels, like I said right at the beginning. And I think you were one of the first people, and I think Renu Aunty will endorse that, who showed that, you know, that strength and support to the material. You know, it came your way, and then eventually all of us kind of decided to produce this film. What was your core instinct when you first read the material that made you want to support it?
There are two, three things, and I'd say that now. One, of course, I've known Junu and Abhay since they were babies. They used to assist Karan, Junu used to. And Renu Aunty I've known for years, and Ravi sir. And I don't know, I'm not very socially good. I don't know how to keep on, how do you say, nurture relationships. But I feel for people for some reason, and that's not the big thing, that I feel for people for some reason. The big thing is that those people feel a lot for me, and I can sense that. So I've always felt Renu Aunty, for some reason, just loves me. And the two kids, I've seen them grow up, and you know, when one of them decided to direct a film, I think apart from the legacy and the fact that they are from films and they want to do this stuff, I thought it was an amazing script. I normally don't have too much sense of script, as Karan would tell you. Karan narrated some other film to me called Kuch Kuch Hota Hai, and it ended up being some other film. Kal Hona Ho, I didn't even hear the script. And he knows I have no sense of scripting and screenplay, and that could be an amazing headline. Shah Rukh has no sense of screenplay, that's why he makes such awful films. But I'm going to try and say things which don't get me in any kind of headline tonight.
It's a bit difficult, no matter what you say.
Right. It's so okay. When I read the script, to be honest, I wanted to be a part of it as an actor. It was so exciting. And I think a better actor than me has essayed that role now, which is Akshaye. and more befitting for the film. Unfortunately, at that time, I had decided to do 3 films, so I couldn't become part of it. I was doing Rais and Fan, and they were physically very hectic. I just loved the way the film had been adapted, turned around, changed a bit, and the product, inshallah, when it comes out, everybody will enjoy it. Apart from that, I remember Yash Ji, a few days before he passed away, Mr. Yash Chopra, he told me the story how he made Ittefaq. And that's an amazing story. He was making some film and there was a break in some film and they went to see this play. And overnight, they all decided to make this film for the B.R. Chopra production. And when I was growing up, it was my mother's favorite film, Ittefaq. And Mr. Rajesh Khanna's first film, maybe, I don't know, or maybe the second, or it was a newcomer at that time. And Nandaji, who nobody could expect anyone else to be but a sister. Okay, sisterly and loving and sweet. And the way that it's very theatrical. It's based on a play, so maybe so. And I found it very, very interesting. And in a country where we don't make too many thrillers, you know, to come across a script which young boys are adapting from a classic, if I may say so, and you know, and bring it to fore, it was extremely exciting. And to Karan's credit, I'm a little lethargic about taking films and getting them cast. But Karan is really good with it. He sees the right people in the right roles. I think that's one of his biggest strengths as a director and a producer. So when he decided on Akshaye and Sidharth and Sonakshi, I thought it was really a fantastic combination. So thank you very much for genuinely making one of my favorite films more relevant for the times today. Because some films, like, you know, I've done Devdas, which would never be better than the classic. Dawn, one has attempted, which would never be better than Bachchan Saab's. But somewhere down the line, just to reintroduce the great cinema that perhaps passes the youngsters by. So Ittefaq is another move in that line. And hopefully the youngsters will really like it.
No, totally. And I think that's why we've had, like, up to this point, we've tried to protect the material of the film. We've tried to, like, which is an internal decision.
That I am the murderer in the film. So just in case.
Yeah, he killed the film.
I do come in the end wearing a singlet. We have a rehashed version of Is a kala kala pe hum tum kare dhamal.
That's all we need.
And that's it.
That's
and
all we need
I'm
to
the
make
murderer,
this
yeah.
film a memorable experience at the end of it all. No, so what we did is we actually protected the film for its in terms of, like, not revealing much, which is why we took this stand of not going out there and promoting it with the actors and leaving them on their own, because you never know.
And those actors seeing. Who are speaking a lot in backstage right now.
Yes, right now.
Shh.
Yeah, those very actors, because I think they both were just speaking, all of them were speaking, they would felt so strange that they haven't been promoting this film. None of them have been out, so it's almost like they're feeling guilty that they have not done enough. So they've been hanging with each other for the last week because they've not been traveling cities, dancing in malls, being in reality shows. It's almost like they feel they haven't done enough. And we had always planned that we'd do this one conference 4 or 5 days ago and, of course, bring Shah Rukh into the forefront, protect you as much as we can. And now that you've announced you're the killer, we haven't really done a great job of protecting you. The film opens with a thank you card to Shah Rukh Khan and Ranbir Kapoor. So either of them could have been the killer, because everybody at interval point was like, is Ranbir Kapoor the murderer? I'm like, but he's not in the film. So how will he be the murderer? But anyway, we're 3 producers on this, which is rare for a film of this scale. But it's more the affection and emotion that brings us together and not just the content of the film. And the fact that we're all here like a strong unit really speaks volumes about the love we feel for the people making it and the ones who have. Without, of course, any further delay, both Shah Rukh and I really want to introduce you to the 2 boys who actually have helmed Ittefaq. I know what it feels like to be a debut director. It's nerve-wracking. It's also exceptionally scary to actually remake your own family lineage film. Because, you know, you can always run the risk of comparison. But yet, he took it heads-on. He's somebody who's been in the zone of filmmaking for so many years. But this is his first piece of work. Always very introverted. Always likes to take a back step. But he's standing next to us, and there's no point he has to be in the foreground now, because we're those kind of boys, men. So please welcome the director of Ittefaq, Abhay Chopra, and the reason you made this. How do you react to these names? Junnu.
Do you hold it against your parents?
Always. Always, but I love the name, and I think it has... Naam sabko yaad rahega. So for me, that works superbly well.
Junnu, I understand, but to have a name after a scare...
So I never say it publicly.
You never say it publicly. That is Boo.
No, it was Abhay.
What is the origin of this name? Where did it come from? Why are you called Boo?
I have no idea. I ask mom that.
But I want to know, when you introduce yourself to girls at a party, how do you say, hi, I'm Boo?
Never.
And how does that work out eventually?
Not going anywhere, so
that's the thrill of Ittefaq. Boo is the thrill of Ittefaq.
Boo is the thrill of Ittefaq. So Boo, your decision very quickly to have made this film, what was that? Was it always because as a child growing up, this was one of the films that you really enjoyed watching of the family films that were made?
Yeah, I think so. I think for me it was... I loved it growing up. I think it was, I always found it ahead of its time. And I think it's, I mean, for me, this is my homage to it. That's it. It's not. Yeah. I'm not remaking it. The original is there.
Yeah.
People can go back and watch it. This is just my version of it.
For all those who will go back and check about the original, the killer of the original, we shouldn't say anything, but is it the corresponding killer, someone else altogether? What is the status of that? Because everybody knows what happened at the end of the 1969 Ittefaq.
I think just let them wait till 3rd of November.
Feb they should not wait for. It would be nice if they wait till the 3rd of
first
November.
Time, yeah.
Feb they might have to see something else. Especially with release dates changing. God knows what's coming in Feb now. But I'm saying that it's quite exciting that you chose to adapt it. And Shah Rukh just said that it was his favorite film. And did you, when you read the script, were you surprised with the end?
I'd be very honest. The film is out in a few days. And I think the one thing... perhaps has been wrongly essayed is it's not really a remake. I think it's quite an original film. The how do you say it? Premise in India, what do they
premise.
Say? Premise. So the premise might be similar. The takeoff point might be similar.
Sorry, Anisha Beg corrects me, it's premise.
It's premise.
Sorry.
Okay. Premise or the premise of this film is perhaps is similar to the 1969 Ittefaq, but when I read the script, it had taken flight of its own. It's very different, and I think a few characters that have been added into this film, which were not present in the theatrical version or the theater version of the original, actually really add a lot to it. So I found that very exciting, that the premise is the same, but... But Boo has made the premise a little more.
Boo and Junu have dutifully kind of done this. Junu, you had a success with Bareilly Ki Barfi, and this is the second offering from BR Films. And I hope it works out really well. So you'll have ended the year from a thriller whodunit to a love story. A great gamut to cover in the same year.
I hope so. And I mean, we are just out here to make films. And like Shah Rukh had told me once, bas aap picture banao, and I will back you. And I've always told him, if I have him and Karan by my side, I don't need anyone else. So I hope we don't disappoint you all, and I hope we can keep making films and get our legacy up there where it was.
That's lovely, and I'm sure it will, because what a tremendous legacy. Like I said, one of the foremost studios of our country and the one that truly believed in story. In fact, just as I said, the only studio that at that point of time, which is given today, had a story development team, which never happened ever in the 60s. It used to be the legacy of BR Films. We have to introduce you now to, of course, the big part of our evening is not the three actors, but the three suspects of Ittefaq. So please welcome all three of them. Different ways they got cast at different junctures of the film. Sidharth Malhotra was actually cast very first, I think, because it was who Boo wanted right at the top. And then after that, it was very amazing how Sonakshi and Akshay just fit so perfectly into the films. So let's begin by calling Sidharth Malhotra. We have at the two ends of our panel, we have two non-nepotistic people, and the remaining in the center are brand ambassadors of nepotism. Sidharth Malhotra and Shah Rukh Khan do not represent nepotism, which also speaks volumes about how both can work equally, efficiently, and correctly, right or not? All right. So normally I would have made everyone sit down, but I think this is working out so well that we're in a semicircle. So I'm going to just start. Sid. This film has been, of course, exciting for you for various reasons, and everyone's talking about who the killer is eventually. Our polls today, we did across the media polls, we did with the media, which is members, thank you so much for voting, all of you, as well as online and television and radio, and the results are quite interesting. Actually, I know them by heart, but I will actually still tell you. The result is quite exciting. It's 31% of the base things Sonakshi is the murderer, 18% think Sid is, 28% say Akshaye Khanna, and 23% think someone else.
Yes.
Is it you?
Is it you?
I've murdered a lot of things, but films, I don't know. So, Sid, what do you have to feel about people who think that you have such an innocent face?
Well, I think that's...
That's for them to judge on this Friday, on the 3rd. And yeah, I think I just want to say I'm really excited to be a part of a murder mystery. I think we don't make enough of them. And for me, this is my first time being accused of murder. And it's been lovely. I think he's extremely talented. I met him years ago, oddly for the same film, and then for some reason never happened. And I think I was meant to be a part of this film, that it happened this time, and it's coming out this Friday. And I hope also for his first film that I think he's worked really hard and he's made a fabulous film, that it works for all of us. And yeah, we'll find out on 3rd now, ki ye poll sach hai ki jhoot hai. Or who won? And is 18, there somebody winning who gets 18, it?
No, well, they just get our intense love if they go to the theatres on Friday.
Okay, so thank
18%
you guys.
Yeah, think yeah. You're innocent, but does that apply to your personal life as well?
On what am I being charged for in my personal
you
life?
Tell me.
For what? No murders in my personal life, only.
No? Whatever. Yeah. Any accusations?
No.
Is there an interrogation?
So a lot of ladies have killed me with their looks. Nothing
they can
else.
Feel you with their looks.
Killed me with their looks.
What is your status? We must tell everyone really wants to know. Because there's so much speculation. Are you single?
I am single.
All right. So that means you won before. There's some shattering
nobody else
noise that happened. I think somebody broke her bangles.
Samal ke.
Who is there? I wonder who that is backstage. Yeah. Kisne apne tode nahi, somebody has said. Theek hai, single hai toh achha hai, it's okay. It opens various doors and these days windows as well. We won't ask you all because we'll ask you after next film because then it'll matter. What about your status? Should we ask you?
Why do you want to know my status? Firstly, I am very upset. I have been the quintessential good girl of Hindi cinema and your 31% people think I have done it.
Because maybe what you're projecting is not what is.
Maybe.
So, are you a seductress or an adulteress in the film?
Well, they're both.
No, they're different.
She has two sides to her.
Okay. Well, there's two sides to me, and I think that is what attracted me to do this film, to be able to play one role in two different ways, and which was most exciting, and to be directed by Boo. I think I must say that when you watch the film, you will not ever think once that this is a first-time director's work. He's done such a fantastic job, and he goes down in the list of my favorite directors. Yeah.
All right, fantastic. And I know that Sonakshi's done an immensely wonderful job, and we can't wait for everyone to see your work on Friday. Akshaye Khanna, truly one of my favorite actors, and we see so little of you all
but
the time.
You never work with me.
Yeah, I have at this time. Listen. I got rejected once by you in my office on a film. Yeah, I wasn't directing. I direct very few films. You said no to Kurban, which, well, we won't talk about how that shaped up eventually. But I'm glad when you came. And again, it was for a cop's role in Ittefaq. And I was telling Juno and Boo, and I'm like, listen, this dude is like really weird. Yeah. He may say yes, he may say no. I have no way of gauging from his tone about what he's going to say. Because, you know, you have a really scary tone, Akshay. You have no tone at all. And that's really scary. Like, we don't know whether you like someone, don't like someone. Like what you hear, don't like what you hear. Why are you like this?
I don't know. I have no clue.
You have no clue why you're like this. I want to tell you, this man, and Shah Rukh said it, fantastic actor. We all know that. We all love him. We see so little of him. Monday to Friday, he's in Bombay. Then he goes to Alibag. Nothing. If he's winning an Academy Award on Saturday, he will not come back because he's in Alibag on Saturday. Yesterday, we had a cast and crew screening for a film where everyone is saying he's done outstandingly. He said, it's too far. I can't come and it's 9 p.m. I'll be asleep by then. I'm like, here, we're in a zone of vanity. I'll go anywhere to see something that I've created, you know? And no matter what time he doesn't go. So again, I ask you, please answer my question. Why are you like this?
Yashraj is too far. I live at Malabar Hill. So I've kept my trial at Famous. So I'll watch it there.
What do you have to say about this? You've worked with Akshay. I mean, you've known him for so many years as well, Shah Rukh.
Yeah, he's extremely reticent and quiet. And that's why perhaps he come across as strange. And which is
never
not
said
true.
Strange.
No, that's why you come across as strange. But I genuinely,
different.
Yeah, I've had few interactions with him, but they're always a little off beat. You know, he's got a different beat that he dances to, and I find that very interesting personally. Also, I met him just now backstage, and then he went and sat in the sofa on the right side, and then somebody said, "Go and talk to him." I said, "Nahi hogi isse baatcheet." Akshay se vartalaap kuch 12-15 din ki ho gayi hai. Ab agli baar se, but you know him so well. I said, yeah, but this is our knowing each other for a very, very long time. Yeah. But I like this not being able to fathom what kind of person he is. And I think in his enactment also, and this is too patronizing for me to be saying it, but I don't mean it patronizingly. I genuinely mean it as an audience. From Himalaya Putra onwards, whenever I've seen him as an actor, and which is seldom, too less, like Karan says. Or maybe that is what is beautiful, that he comes once in a way, and when he comes, he really, really creates something unfathomable as an actor. I really, really appreciate your acting here. And this is honest truth. Having said that, why you're like this, I can also ask you, why the hell are you like this, man?
Well, I think Sid, Sonakshi and Akshay had a tremendous kind of interesting synergy on set. I think they were like three completely different energies colliding. Sonakshi coming from a certain space, Akshay from a certain space, and Sid from a certain space as well. But I think the impact of what they brought to the table, and that has a lot to do with the director who kind of brought them together.
And their home-cooked food. Yeah. All thanks to auntie.
Yeah.
Yeah. Unka namak khaya, inka sab kuch, inki roti jo, diet food sab kuch khaya. Yeah. So I think that was our lunchtime every day on set where we all bonded in the first few days. And we kept it going. We kept that culture going. All throughout shoot, we've always had our meals together. All thanks to Junu and Boo and Auntie right here for feeding us. And I think they're one of the warmest producers. And they make you feel, the whole set was feeling like a family. It has a very ghrelu vibe, which was very nice. I think.
Well, that's correct, Sid. I mean, that's well said, because it's after a long time that you go on a film set and you feel that vibe, because we've all become so intensely corporate in our demeanor and, you know, all about work and everything is official and everything is work-like. And I think on this particular film, it all came together as one big strong unit. Now, this is us, the team of Ittefaq. The film releases November 3rd. Our request to all of you, if you can put it out there to everyone, is to please not reveal the end, is to really put no spoilers out, because this film is all about eventually its narrative, its journey and its eventual destination. And if you reveal the destination, it'll still be exciting, but that 10% zyada maza that you will get when you don't know the end is always going to be much more exciting for you to watch. So if you can communicate, because you are our family as well, and if you really put this out there, it'll help us all.
Kaam aaya to family bana liya isne.
Release. It's all about loving all of you.
Alap is going on.
मैं आलाप जब मैं बात करता हूँ तो मेरे पीछे पीछे आलाप आ ही रहा है इट्स अ सबकॉन्शियस इन माय हेड माय ओन लोगोस गोइंग ऑन इन द बैग वी आर गोइंग टू ओपन दिस क्वेश्चन अ फ्यू क्वेश्चंस फ्रॉम ऑल ऑफ यू एंड वी आर हैप्पी टू आंसर देम रिलेटेड टू द फिल्म एंड सिड्स पर्सनल लाइफ
चेक चेक हाय दिस आलोक ऑन योर लेफ्ट
अरे आई वाज वेटिंग आलोक कहाँ हो शुरू बोनी तो आप ही से होती है
सर मेरा सवाल मंच पे मौजूद सभी लोगों से है कि इस फिल्म के अलावा कोई ऐसा इत्तेफाक आपकी जिंदगी में या करियर वाइज हुआ हो जो आप शेयर
करेंगे आपकी जिंदगी में कोई इत्तेफाक मोमेंट हुआ है
खान साहब आप शुरू करें और सिद्धार्थ उसे खत्म कर सकते हैं कोई ऐसा इत्तेफाक इस फिल्म के अलावा जो आपको अभी याद आता हो करियर या जिंदगी में
मैं उन्हीं लोगों की बात करूंगा यार जो यही बहुत बड़ा इत्तेफाक है कि हम लोग एक दूसरे को बहुत सालों से जानते हैं अलग अलग मौकों पर मिले हैं बट या करण से मैं इत्तेफाक से ही मिला था When his father got him on the... Is it right? Karan Arjun? I was shooting Karan Arjun and main SG se baat kar raha tha. And he had got his roly-poly son along. And he said, ye mera beta. At that time, he didn't want to be in films, I think. He didn't want to make films. And I think perhaps, more than me, perhaps Adi, but even being in touch with me kind of convinced him that theek hai, main film mein banata hun because my dad is... and I still remember his dad was also not so keen because he wasn't keen. So I think ये इत्तेफाक की बात है कि हम लोग एक जगह पर अजीब से मिले मैं जाती हूँ मैं गाना कर रहा था एंड ही मेट मी एंड ही थॉट आई थिंक माय शूज और माय शर्ट वाजंट वेल फिटिंग और ही फाउंड मी नॉट फैशनेबल इनफ
He was wearing an orange denim yeah, shirt. And denim I shirt. Called up Kajal that morning because I knew she was on set. My father wanted me to go on that film set. And he was like, Aja mere saath, you must take rounds with me. Producers rounds lete hain. You know, har jagah jate hain. You know, you must come with me. So, jaati hu main, to maine Kajal ko bola that I don't know anybody on set. She said, yeah, come there. The song is going on and on and on for 8 days. So, you come and we'll sit together. Then I met Shah Rukh. And my impression of movie stars up to that point was like, that, you know, they and especially Shah Rukh, there were lots of stories about like, oh, he's... Like, which I've written in my book about the first time I even saw him. But I have to say it now because I'm talking about it. But I went for a screen test for a TV serial that I was acting in. It was called Indradhanush. I was sitting in a room and it was 10 o'clock and the director was Anand Mahendru. He hadn't stepped out till about 2. And opposite me, there was a man who was drinking tea and doing the crossword for 4 hours. I didn't know who he was. Anand Mendru walks out after 4 hours, goes across the room and goes to this gentleman who's standing there. He says, "So sorry, main late ho gaya." Late ho gaya meaning 4 ghante late. It's not being late, but anyway, it's being on another level of late. But this man just stood up and said, "No, no, it's okay. I like the chai in your office and I wanted to finish the crossword. And I don't want to do this serial. I just came to tell you that." So he said, "You waited 4 hours to tell me you don't want to do a serial." So he said, "Yeah, but I just like the tea in your office." And anyway, that man left and Anand Mendru came towards me and said, "Ow, ow, ow, I'm so happy to see you. You're quite fat," because he wanted a really fat boy for the part. So I said, "Thank you, I'm really quite fat." And so he said, I said, "Does that mean I got the part?" He said, "Yeah, yeah, you are getting the part. But look at that man, you know who he is?" I said, "No, he's saying he's an actor called Shah Rukh Khan." So I said, "Oh, I don't know." He said, "He's done a serial called 4G and he's stupid to let go. Look at this boy, I'm going to make him into a big star. He's going to do it." And I looked at that man and yeah, I was like, "Cool." And he said, "That Shah Rukh Khan ka kuch nahi hoga." That was my memory of Shah Rukh Khan, who was on the first time. And then I meet him in 1993, like about 5 years later. And he was warm and he was so wonderfully respectful to my father. And I think he had me at hello just that day. That was my big Ittefaq moment.
Akshay, Sonakshi.
I think the biggest Ittefaq is that my dad did Ravi sir's first film and I'm doing Boo's film. I think isse bada Ittefaq kya ho sakta.
और आप हमारी बात क्योंकि नहीं सुन रहे मैं वापस बोल देती हूँ माय डैड वाज सपोज्ड टू डू द ओरिजिनल इत्तेफाक एंड वो नहीं हो पाया तो अब मैं हूँ सो लाइफ इज कम फुल सर्कल एंड ये बहुत बड़ी इत्तेफाक है
जुनो सिद्धार्थ
I think just coming together with all of them, I knew Karan as an assistant, I knew Shahrukh the first time aiding for Karan. And it was just beautiful how they all came and helped us in our time of need and I mean liked what they heard and I mean I think that itself is a ittefaq.
Yeah, I think talking about the film, before I had met him, actually I met Boo about when I was doing Ek Villain 3 or 4 years ago. And tab, for whatever reason, the film didn't happen at that time. And that time, ek hi producer tha. So, ittefaq sir, teen saal baad mile, to yahan teen producer aa gaye hain. And Karan got involved. And I did the film today, so I feel it was meant to be again. And yeah, we're pretty happy that everyone came together.
And I think Boo's biggest ittefaq moment is ittefaq itself. I think this is his big, it doesn't get bigger than this ittefaq moment. Yeah, ladies and gentlemen, many other questions we have from the house? Yes, sir. Hanji. Because it happened one night. IT is for it. It was part of Rahul Nanda, but the happened one night has vanished. It was there in the first creative. The IT in red is because of the it happened one night. And the blood is because it's about a double murder. Yeah, it says that I don't like plain things. I like things that come with extra drama. Today, in fact,
and he needs a new designer.
I changed my shoes because Akshay found my shoes objectionable, the ones I wore in the afternoon. Yeah. He looked at them and he said, "I can't bear your shoes." So I got scared and I changed them because I'm scared of Akshay, I've told you.
We are witness to this.
Hi, I would like to...
Karan?
Okay.
Yes, I mean, I think that the fact that we haven't promoted it has just built intrigue for a film like this. I'm not saying that this should be, you employ this as a device for every film. But for this particular genre, this space of film, I felt it was integral that we don't go out there and speak about it time and again. Because A, it carries the issue would be that you would sound repetitive. We said the same things again and again because we can't reveal much. And B, I think building intrigue is everything. So I'm certainly satisfied with the film. And I think that eventually will speak for itself. I'm more than satisfied. I think we make too few of them because we tend to laden them with a lot of, because a thriller cannot work when you put 6 songs in it because then it stops being thrilling because you're stopping, you're singing, then you start again. So a thriller really works when it's songless and this one is songless.
Sorry?
Oh
yeah, I think it's really, I mean personally, one of my favorite genres is thrillers. I really enjoy them. And I could see like a film like Usual Suspects or whatever. Whenever I'm bored, I'll just put on Usual Suspects, knowing everything about it, even the lines. And I think, yeah, we do make very few thrillers in this country. And I don't know if that's because our films are laden with songs, and that is the reason, like Karan said. But he knows well, so maybe he understands that better. But I feel whatever the reason, we just make very few of them. You know, there was Kanoon, many years ago. Then there is apna, I think you've done a couple with Abbas Mustan.
So many of your films, sir, in the beginning.
Bazigar, maybe.
Yes, so many of your films.
I'm please not saying that was the only one, but I think since then, not very many, except one.
I think a quintessential Hamras thriller would be Kahani. Kahani is a thriller. The way that we try to channelize this film has been that songless story content thriller.
Hello. I would like to ask the lead pair, Sidharth and Sonakshi, how did it feel when you guys didn't go out full on like promoting the film? Usually you all are used to aggressive promotions.
It felt great.
I felt really guilty. I feel I'm not used to it. I think it's our first time. We're not used to it. We're kind of confused.
Yeah.
So she's very happy.
No, I'm loving it also because the kind of response the trailer of this film got, I felt like, you know, everybody just really connected with it and took to it. So I felt like we didn't have to go there and repeat all the same things. Like he said, it gets repetitive. We get asked the same questions. We have to... Honestly, promoting a film has become tougher than actually filming it. So I was very happy and, you know, for the first time. It's refreshing even for an actor to be able to just sit back and gauge an audience's reaction from where we're standing instead of like going out there. It's nice.
I think the important thing to know is that normally we make a lot of films which are template driven. You know, they're similar, the commercial films that we make. And for those, you need to go out and say, look, it's the same template, but we are trying to present it to you differently. And that's what happens in the nice ones and the bad ones. But I think this film, two reasons, I think, between Apurva, Gaurav, the whole team, the budgets have been kept because by the genre itself, the story itself, it's not a very phailava film. And I think this film will be liked and loved and appreciated for the content more than anything else. Not any less for the acting they've done, obviously, or the direction that happens or the writing. But I think the content is going to be really important for the film. So when the content is going to be so important, and we can't show a lot of it by the genre itself, ki dikha denge sab kuch. So to talk about it, the less spoken about it, more seen and presented, I think, would be better for Ittefaq. So I think the strategy which Karan and his team devised, I think, is really, really nice for this film. And the actors also, again, in a film like this, it's very character-driven. It's not a hero type or a stereotype. So I think that also becomes interesting, a part of storytelling when it unfolds. So it's nicer that it's kept kind of under wraps, and now slowly it'll open up and inshallah explode into some really nice, thrilling moments in the film.
Also, yeah.
Karan. Oh, we're in negotiation for some of that right now. We can't confirm that till it really happens.
Karan.
I think we've done a whole... we gave you a book on Ittefaq. On the set, the Ittefaq is that everyone showed up on time. And we managed to shoot the film.
There was a time we thought we'll all watch it together at home, but I don't know if that happens because everybody's gonna be busy. But I'll meet you all on the second here and spend some time with you. And yeah,
make sure you ask him about Ittefaq. That's my request, because since you all will meet him on the second, ek 5 minute agar aap Ittefaq ke bare mein de de to thoda additional push mil jayega.
Kyun tu to keh raha tha marketing nahi karni.
Are main kuch to log kahenge, logo ka kaam hai to bolne ke liye, to main kuch bhi bol leta hu.
Hello, Karan.
उस दिन कर देना, अभी तो हुआ नहीं. Hello, अभी तो Karan, दो तीन दिन बाकी
हैं. I am very young at 45. I don't know what in.
Karan, yeah. Ittefaq was a songless film. In this film, Raat Baki, Baat Baki, वो गाना.
It's promotion.
It's not in the film.
ये फिल्म में नहीं है. Please do write it. I think somebody got sued for it. ये गाना इस फिल्म में नहीं है.
ये गाना इस फिल्म में नहीं है.
तो धर्मा प्रोडक्शन की तरफ से, बीआर फिल्म्स की तरफ से और रेड चिलीज की तरफ से हमें सू नहीं करना. ये गाना फिल्म
मत करना. बहुत सारे हमारे प्रमोशनल वीडियो है. आई कांट हैंडल एनी मोर लीगल मैटर्स फॉर नो रीजन. आई बेग यू, आई डोंट वॉन्ट बी सूड अगेन.
अच्छा, सोनाक्षी, Did you watch the original Ittefaq? Because Nanda ji's performance was hailed as, you know, un zamane mein was, you know, she was highly appreciated.
Ji, I've heard, but no, I haven't seen the film. Kyunki Karan ne mujhe kaha tha.
Actually, ek aur Ittefaq hai.
Yeah, ek aur Ittefaq hai ki hum tino ne.
Puri cast ne purani Ittefaq nahi dekhi hai.
Purani wali Ittefaq.
None of us have seen it.
Aur honestly,
jab paida hue hoge to dekhi hogi.
69 ke.
तीनों ने नहीं देखी।
सोनाक्षी, उस पिक्चर में नंदा ने एक ही साड़ी में पूरी पिक्चर शूट की थी।
जी जी जी।
तो आपके लिए, मुझे नहीं पता इसमें कितने कॉस्ट्यूम चेंज करने का मौका मिला आपको, बट जब ऐसा नहीं होता है तो वो एक्सपीरियंस कैसा होता है? यूजुअली आपको अलग अलग कॉस्ट्यूम्स और ये समझते
हैं। मैं एक बात तो कहना चाहती हूँ, मैं इतनी कंफर्टेबल मैं कोई फिल्म में नहीं रही हूँ, क्योंकि मैं एक नाइटी पहन के मैंने पूरी फिल्म शूट की है तो मैं बड़ी खुश थी।
तो वो घर उठते ही आ जाती थी सेट पे।
तो मैं I'm ready. मैं आ गई। It was the most comfortable film I've shot.
Siddharth, अपनी आपकी पिछली फिल्म द जेंटलमैन वॉज ऑल्सो अ थ्रिलर, एक्चुअली दिस इज ऑल्सो अ थ्रिलर, बोथ फ्रॉम धर्मा, ये भी एक इत्तेफाक
Hi, Karan. This is Karan towards the center. This is Priyanka from Indian Express. So we've been hearing a lot that you and Shahrukh might collaborate for a project. I think you also narrated him some idea, which I don't know if it worked out or not. But could you say something about that? Is there something?
तुम्हें सब कुछ ही मालूम है, तुम ही बता दो ना यार।
जो बाकी की information है वो आप बता दीजिए. So is there something happening?
More than me saying, you should read about it when it happens.
Shahrukh, if you could say something on that.
No, me and Karan always share a lot of ideas, to be honest, till we come on to a specific one, unless Karan already uske paas koi na koi ek kahani ekdam ready hai jo mere liye hai. To hum bahut milte hain yaar, kabhi kabhar production ke liye, jaise ye film hai, kabhi kabhar ek dusre ke saath, kabhi ye jo banana cha rahe hain mere bina, kabhi wo wali jo mere saath. So we discuss a lot, you know, we aisa nahi hum tabhi milte hain jab hum ek hi film ki baat kar rahe hain. So there have been lot of discussions over the last 2 years now. Before that, he was 1.5 years because Air Dil mein he was busy. So yeah, we keep discussing, but we really haven't honed on to anything as yet, because now we've reached a stage and age where when we do a film together as director actor, then dono ko bahut khushi honi chahiye beyond everything else. You know, it should be different. It should be, like he said, we are blamed for kind of always making similar films about family and all. I think we all have had guts now and experience to try something nicer, wilder, cooler, differenter than what we've done before. So yeah, we do meet for a lot of ideas, and we are so close to each other, sometimes we can reject it outright without thinking he'll feel bad or I'll feel bad. Nahi yaar, mujhe nahi karni aa rahi hai, ye mat, tu bhi mat bana. So we have a lot of discussions like that.
Right. On that note,
ladies and gentlemen, we'll have to call that. That was our last question from the house. We have to really thank. But before we, I go on and say my thank you to all of you for being here, for bearing with us, and for supporting our film like you always have, I'd like to call Renu Aunty on stage. Yeah. Please come on stage. On Dharma Productions, Red Chillies, and BR Films, we are very blessed to work with senior members of the industry and remake such an honorable film that was set in 1969. Shahrukh, we always thank you for starting the process and setting the ball rolling on. एक मिनट, मैं एंड करता हूँ भाई, वोट ऑफ थैंक्स दे रहा हूँ. शाहरुख, थैंक यू फॉर सेटिंग द बॉल रोलिंग इन द राइट डायरेक्शन. अक्षय, फॉर अग्रीइंग टू डू दिस फिल्म, एंड फॉर माय रिक्वेस्ट पर्सनली एज अ फिल्म मेकर इज फॉर यू टू डू मच मोर वर्क, बिकॉज़ वी लव वॉचिंग यू ऑन सेल्यूलॉइड एंड यू आर टेरिफिक. रिनो आंटी, फॉर मदरिंग द फिल्म लाइक यू डू मदर एवरीवन एल्स, इंक्लूडिंग योर टू लवली बॉयज एंड योर डॉटर, बट फॉर दिस फिल्म. सोनाक्षी, फॉर बींग योर सेल्फ एंड फॉर ऑलवेज ब्रिंगिंग दैट पॉजिटिविटी. टू बू, फॉर अ ग्रेट जर्नी अहेड, great, great movies to make and so many stories to tell. Welcome to the movies. For being his strong support and being such a strong storyteller yourself, and for Sid, for being family to me, to Dharma, to every film we ever make. I love you deeply and will always.
And thank you, Karan.
And I just want to say, you know, when couple of production houses ever come together, there are a lot of ups and downs, but I think we should thank the team of Dharma, Red Chillies and BR Films, that there was not even once a discussion, whether it's the marketing, whether it's the production on ground, whether it's the monies. Everything has happened so smoothly. And I think that is the kind of culture which this film has promoted through the gracious and goodnessness of Renu Aunty. And of course, the two boys whose names really need to be changed. Nobody's going to take you seriously.
Directed by Boo.
Nobody's going to take you guys seriously. So Junu and Boo. And thank you, cast. Sid and Sonakshi and Akshay, thank you for being part of this. And God bless you all. Yeah,
thank you. And we will now proceed for photo op.